Keep it simple, keep it real. Staying connected, that's the deal. The worst feeling when you get your new high-tech toy. My connectors are wrong. This gives me no joy. In this video, I really just want to quick discuss all the popular connectors that are used in 4G and 5G devices these days, just to make sure that you know what to look for and which one do you need to select. But before I do that, do remember to stay connected to RF Shop so you can be up to date on what we do, and also click that bell so you'll see when we upload any new videos. Okay, so let's get into it. In this video, I just really want to talk about the most common ones that are used for 4G and 5G. There's of course a bucket load of other connectors as well that we under this RF Shop brand can talk about, but I'm not going to talk about that here or probably ever. These ones are just for everyday users that they're buying an antenna, or they want to buy an antenna, they want to buy a modem, but suddenly it's like, what is going on here? So I have it broken into four connectors: the TS9 connectors, SMA connectors, SMA connector reverse polarity, and N-type connectors. So I'll talk those four connectors because those are the ones that you commonly find in the actual devices that we use. First one, TS9 connector. Now the TS9 connector is one that gets used in the Netgear NightHawks and also the Huawei B818. So the first thing is, and I have this camera here right next to me so I could do some close-up videos. It's a little push-in connector. It's quite delicate on the inside. Delicate, fragile, choice of word, depends what you think. So definitely when you look at it, it's a push-in connector. There are other ones available that are very similar. They're not relevant to these modems, and these are the modems that are currently most popular. So I'm not going to mention the other ones that are out there because it's just going to confuse it. So just think TS9 at the moment for NightHawk, a B818, and some of the other models is the one to go for. And we'll see on our packages, our kits and so forth, we always try to include one of these in there because we know the likelihood is very high that you're going to use this one. So now I have the NightHawk M5 from my hand, and just like with the M2, at the bottom there's the base. So there's two little plastic caps. You'll open those. You see there is the two TS9 pigtails. That's what they look like. So really small, really delicate. This little connector, if it's a good fit, which I dare say I think ours is really good, it goes in, but you do have to be careful. Don't push it too hard. But also, if it's too loose, do you have a problem? So you push it in. That's really it. It's just a gentle push. And there's a second one. Remember, there's two antenna ports. You want to go for MIMO, M-I-M-O, which basically it configures it for a 2x2 antenna system. It pushes in, and there you go. That's it. In is in. Don't go deeper. You'll see there is a gap at the back. That is fine. Don't push it deeper, because you push it deeper, there's going to be more. So when it's in, it's in. Once you've connected it like this, it's connected, and you can do whatever else you want to do with the rest of the device itself. So that's on the NightHawk M5. You would do the same on the previous generation, the NightHawk M2. You have two rubber caps there. Lift off, they push in there. Again, you'll see it's exactly the same connector type. You see the same there. Awesome. And also on the, this is, well, similar to the B818. This is the CPE Pro, but there's a little cap at the back you lift. I've done this on another video as well. And you'll see again, it looks exactly the same. So all you do, just make sure you lined up, push it in. When it's in, it's in. You'll see again, there's a little gap there. It feels like it has to go deeper. Don't push it deeper in. That's it, that's TS9, TS9. Hello, Stella. Ah, come on, Stella. Ah, I'm just gonna continue here, but get off. Guess what, I'm at home. carry on, definitely. So that's the TS9, that's the NightHawk. The next one, which is my favorite connector, not just before for 4G reasons, but also for all sorts of other applications, is SMA connector. SMA, literally those three letters. SMA connectors are always used on the Teltonika routers. I have a Teltonika RUTX 11 with me, just because there's many of those to show. You'll see on our little pigtails we have TS9 on one end, so that we have a SMA, this golden one on the other side. First of all, how do you know it's SMA? The dimension on the thread, roughly about 6 millimeters. So you see it's much smaller than my pinky or so forth. The nut itself, which is often used on the pointing antennas, That's an 8mm nut that would screw straight onto the SMA. So the male goes into the female. In RF world, in our radio world, this is a female. This is a jack. So the one that's in the body with the thread on the outside, we call a jack. This is the male. It's a male nut that's on the outside. It's an 8mm size. But please do not use your local range or go for your into the garage and take one of your 8mm spanners and just over torque this. It actually, there is officially in the defense industry and in the aeronautics industry, they always use proper torque spanners with the correct values to torque this up. If you do it at home, like when you do here, finger tight. Just go finger tight and just maybe, no, not even force it, but don't take any spanner, don't take anything, any range or anything, and take it further. If it connects, it connects. That is all good, please. And of course, if you have funding for a torque spanner, do use a torque spanner. But for every home user, just use your fingers, nothing more than that. That's the SMA. So SMA gets used on 4G and 5G technologies. Can't say it's always the case, but it's definitely a general rule of thumb. They are most often gold-plated. So you'll see them as gold-plated connectors. Again, there's no golden rule for that, so the gold plating is not a given. There are silver and there are stainless steel versions of the same connector type. But for your general applications, you are, I don't know, we can't put a number to it, 90%, 99% sure it's going to look like this golden connector I have here in my hand. Now, the next problem is really that there's another SMA variant called the RPSMA. RPSMA stands for reverse polarity SMA. It has nothing to do with the actual stuff on there, the actual signals or anything. It just has to do with the gender of the inner pin, reverse polarity or gender. So you'll see on the one that I mentioned earlier, what you can see is basically there's a socket and the outer thread. That's the female. That's an SMA jack or an SMA female. The reverse polarity version has a pin. So it is still a female body, but it has a male pin. That's where the reverse or the opposite comes into play. The reason they do that is for Wi-Fi and for all these what we call free or unlicensed bands, you want the reverse. So you don't want people to connect one of those antennas onto a licensed band such as, you know, there's licenses dedicated for the 4G and 5G network operators and technologies. So just be really aware of that and do not make the mistake of putting the wrong connector antenna on the wrong one, because it is possible. First of all, if you put a male pin against a male pin, so you put a classic male, which, where's my connectors? Where's my end of one? Yeah, okay. If I had a male like that, in theory, I can try to squeeze it into that, male to male. And I have the it will thread and it will go in. It will, but you'll see that the pins, once they clash, they will actually, they're in the dark. They'll actually just bend, so something's going to break. So that's bad. The other way is if you have a reverse polarity male, so in other words, you have a male body with a socket and you try to put it into this one, that'll work. You can get it in there. But because it's female socket, there's no electrical connection, so you're not going to get any result out of that. So reverse polarity is a nasty one to be aware of, and to make sure that when you say Wi-Fi, look at the connector inside, put it in the right one. That's SMA. Now, the last one is probably from a practicality perspective my favorite, and that's N-type connectors. Just the word N, but we say type, so N-type connector. There's X-Pol 2, but the variant I have here is with the N-type female on it. So you'll see that's a bigger connector. Dimension-wise, I was thinking how to say that, but it's probably, like if you look at it, the female has it looks like a pin, but it's actually a socket because it's hollow, and the male pin would go into the socket itself there. This is probably about a normal finger thick finger diameter. The dimension will be shown on the screen. The male is probably like a thumb. So if you look at the connector and you see, well, what connector is this? Look at your thumb. If it is as big as your thumb, it's probably an N-type connector. Always silver looking. So this one, the most common plating that you would see looks shiny and silver. That's probably nickel plated. If you look at the more high-end connectors, like Jibo also does that, and a lot of the other connector suppliers, Ruben and Suna, Telegatner, those guys, it looks silver colored, but it's not as shiny. It's actually a matte, and that's because it's a different plating type. It's the tri-alloy plating or a different layer. So this is nickel plated. The other one is a higher end plating. It's still fine. It works perfectly fine in these technologies that we do here. But if you look at the higher end technologies, again, marine dedicated applications, defense applications, space applications, automotive, that kind of stuff, you really want to go for the higher end. But for these mainstream, just proper connectors, the nickel plating is perfectly fine. That's an N-type connector that gets used on probably vast majority of these antennas. Look at your the Bolton long ranger behind me has this kind of N-type connector. The Lock periodic dipoles, right, like the big antennas, they have N-type connectors on. Yagi antennas have N-type connectors on. So this is a very common connector to use for something that goes on the outside. They are waterproof on the inside. So once sealed, it is actually waterproof on the inside of the connector. Then they put some amalgamated tape to seal the whole thing up so that it's a proper waterproof solution. But already when you have a male to female, that's a waterproof RF connection. So that's definitely one of the main reasons why it gets used outside. It's just, it's easy to mount. It is big enough that you can finger tight it without any trouble. It is waterproof and it's easy to work if you're up standing on the roof or if you are really doing a big install work. You don't want to mess around with difficult connectors and delicate connectors. That's all I have to say about that. Just to recap quickly, TS9, SMA, N-type connectors. And the last one that I put it last because it's kind of my least favorite, but it's just as important, is the reverse polarity SMA. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye.